because, you know, when you're on stage, you have to present yourself as a complete package, because when an audience is coming, whether even with show production point of view, where when an artist is going and listening to you, or he's not come to only listen to you, he's come to take back an experience. You know, when you go, just a small example, when you go for these concerts in which these DJs perform, they're actually doing nothing, but just the whole means they're mixing the tracks, and all, but they're not like, they have really slogged it out in the studios to actually come out with a kick-ass track. That's why they're there performing for 50,000 people. But the whole experience that you take back when you go to that kind of concert, it's the lights, it's the graphics, it's the vibe. You know, as an artist, we all need to keep those things in mind, how we can syncopate these graphics with your songs, how you can, you know, which point of time, how you can interact with the audience, how you can interact with your musicians on stage, how you can do some sort of an audience interaction, make them sing. You know, when you make them a part of your show, they automatically feel more connected with you. So these are some things that I personally like look into, like, you know, they're very important to overall push the level of your level of the performance and the experience that the audience takes.
I have this one thing I keep telling my band, that I want to put up a show wherein the audience should not want to check WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram in the middle of the show. That's the show I want. I want them to be glued to the show, whether it's sonically, visually, or the, like he said, the production value of the show should be so high, because that's where we're heading. That's the future of music. When you're going to a live show, if it's going to sound like how it does on your iPod or on your music device, what
the arrangements you can do, new arrangements.
There's so much
you
can do with a track, because that's what you're giving the audience, and that's what we must look into that. One thing that really connects people is the internet today. And the fact that anyone who has a phone, a smartphone, can just put it up on a selfie mode and sing a song and put it on the internet.
He can be a star,
which is what Amir Khan's film is about. Secret superstar.
Yeah.
And that is actually very true. And we must take these platforms seriously and use it to our advantage. So like you said, that there's this boy, immensely talented, sitting in a small village, doesn't have the money to come to Mumbai. But he can make a beginning like this. There's internet everywhere.
A YouTube channel, khulo, or dalo video and see what happens. Now, see, this power was not there 15 years back, 10 years back. Today, because of the internet, it has just broken all boundaries. You know, an artist like Vidya Walks, who's an internet superstar, she's in America and she's extremely popular here in India. Usse Mumbai aane ki nahi zarurat padi. Exactly what people from the smaller towns can also do. It's no more a problem. And if you obviously want to come to Bombay, that's a different thing. What happens is the whole industry functions out of here. If you want to go and meet some, people who you are inspired by, if you can get that opportunity, it's always great. But that's not the end of the world. You know, jaise pehle hota tha shayad.
Add one more thing. Anybody who's not in Mumbai, who wants to come to Mumbai and thinks Mumbai mein aane ke baad sab mere to ho hi jayega.
Woh aisa bhi nahi hai.
Aisa bhi nahi hai. Come with a plan. Come with many plans. Come with plan A, B, C, D, because this is a tough city to be in. It's a tough city to, for us who live here. I was born here in Mumbai, and I still feel the struggle when I'm in the industry.
We all feel the struggle, and it's not easy. It doesn't come easy to anybody.